Hey guys, Philosopher here, and today we have the Path to Power Guide. This is a guide for new players or for mid-game players who are trying to grow their rosters, and the goal of this guide is to teach you how to grow your roster to be as powerful as possible as quickly as possible. So if that's interesting to you, buckle up, because we got a lot of tips here. The goal here for this guide is not to tell you what to do. I know there's a lot of new player guides out there that are like, farm this node, then farm that node, then build this team. That is not what this guide is going to do. This guide will help you with some of those things, but my goal is not to tell you where to fish. It's to teach you how to fish. I want to teach you how to build your roster well. I want to teach you how to build your roster efficiently, how to play the game the right way so that you can become powerful quickly. All right, what do you need to know for becoming powerful quickly? Well, one thing you should understand about this game is that while people call it a hero collector game, it's really a resource management game. So there's different resources. Like up here, we have gold, power cores, energy. This is ISO energy. And then over time, you're going to farm not only character shards for characters, but you're going to farm things like gear, right, that you're going to use to build the characters up. Things like, you know, for example, these little pieces right here. So, you know, all of those different pieces are different resources that you can use to make your roster stronger. And what your goal is to try to use those resources in the most efficient way possible to get your roster as powerful as possible, as quickly as possible. Now, look, there are other ways to play the game. You could just have fun and upgrade your favorite characters. But if you actually want to succeed at the different content in the game, you're going to need to pay attention. Because, hint, hint, Scopely doesn't give you all the resources you might want. They're limited. You're going to be on a budget. And on top of that, there's something called power creep. Well, what do I mean by power creep? What I mean is that when you go to your roster, when you look at all these characters, some of them are more powerful than others. Right now, in March 2021, Silver Surfer might be the most powerful character in the game. He was just introduced. Then there's a lot of these characters out in here who just aren't very powerful at all. But here's the thing. When they were first introduced in the game, they were powerful. Yondu used to be one of the most powerful characters in the game. And that makes sense. Because when the character comes into the game, Scopely wants you to invest in that character. They want you to put resources into that character. If the character sucked, if it wasn't at least as good or better than all the characters in the game already, then you wouldn't do that, right? You just keep using the characters you already had. And so what this means is that some of the older characters actually aren't very good. And there's a slow power creep over time as all the new characters get better and better. It's sort of like when you go to a used car dealership, or a new car dealership, I should say, and buy your new car. You got your new 2021 car. As soon as you drive it off the lot, it loses value. Over time, it loses more and more value and goes down in value over time. That's what happens with characters. So a lot of the way of succeeding in this game is to invest in characters that are going to hold their value over time and to try to get the most out of the investments you make. That's what we're going to try to do. Now, just to be clear, while you're doing most of the stuff in this game solo, there is a team element to this game, and that's part of finding an alliance. So you definitely want to find the right alliance in the game. And if you join an alliance, which is a group of 24 players who work together, you'll be able to unlock some new war modes here, Alliance War, and then there's something called Alliance Raids. These are important game modes. I'm not going to get into the specifics here, but you definitely need to do that right away. If you don't have an alliance yet, or you just got placed into a starter alliance and there's no one else in it, go to the link below. There's a link to the official MSF Discord, and you just go there, and there's a special channel, and you can go and look for an alliance, and you'll find tons of alliances that want you to join them. So do that first before doing anything else, because look, you want to be able to use all the different game modes. And not all of them will be available to you at your starting level, but over time you'll unlock things like real-time arena, dark dimension, like I said before, war and raids, you'll have blitz, and then you're going to have something that called arena. So what is actually the important stuff for you to focus on? Well, in the early game, it's going to be arena. Why is that? Because the rewards from arena are very significant. These purple things here are called power cores, and they're like premium currency. You could buy them with real money if you wanted to. They also give these things called arena credits that you can use to unlock characters. Well, there's also something, though, as you get further in the game. So, by the way, arena, all the characters in your arena are going to be characters that started at the same time as you. So it's equal from that perspective. And really, the players who do well in arena are the players that efficiently grow their rosters over time, don't waste their resources, because they're going to outcompete the people who started at the same time that they did. Now, when you get to Dark Dimension, that is what I would say is the new focus, and this should be your number one focus in the game. Obviously, in the beginning, it's not open to you when you first start the game. It gets opened when you get to a higher level. But once you unlock Dark Dimension, you know, once you're in the level 60s and above, that is when you need to start focusing on building a Dark Dimension team. Why Dark Dimension? Why is this so important? Well, actually, Dark Dimension has some of the most amazing levels of resources in the game that you can get. So, for example, with Dark Dimension 1, you get just tons of gear. 1,320 of these orange gear pieces, which are, of course, the most powerful than 1980 on your second run. These are some of the most important pieces in the game to build your roster. Dark Dimension 2 not only gives you tons of orange gear, but also gives you a character called Ultron, who's super powerful. You might know him from the movies or from the comics. Dark Dimension 3 gives you even more oodles of gear. And Dark Dimension 4 gives you tons and tons of gear. And it gives you Doctor Doom, who's still currently one of the top few characters in the game. So you want to focus on Dark Dimension. That is going to be your number one focus. But then after that, your second priority will be Arena. And then your third priority is going to be Raids, specifically the Ultimus Raids, which is where you're going to start as a newer player with your alliance. This is where you work together to defeat enemies on a map. Okay, there'll be a different map, and you'll work together to defeat the enemies on the map. Here you go. There's different enemies there that you'll work to defeat together, and you'll get rewards, okay? So here's some rewards for this raid, for example. You'll probably end up starting, whether it's an Ultimus 4, or 5, or 6, and you'll work together with your alliance. And you're going to need to have characters that you'll use on your raid team. You'll have to have your arena team, and then you'll have to have Dark Dimension teams. So you might be thinking to yourself, oh my god, do I need to have three teams? Well, not necessarily. The most efficient way to do this is to build one team that you can use in all these game modes. That's where you want to start. Now, a lot of guides that are out there tell you to choose a team that you're basically going to discard after a period of time. Like, oh, just use a starter team of characters that suck past a certain point. I don't believe in that. I think the most efficient way is actually to build a team that you can use in the end game, so you can use throughout the entire life of your account. And so that's why I ask that you take a look at the infographic below, the starter team's infographic, which I'm going to put on the screen now. Now, this is the starter team infographic, I should just say, is in fact, infographic that I've created with Voltage Sauce, who is the head of the Beginners Discord. And what we've done here is broken down what the best teams are for new players. Now, it's got the different layers here of player that could play the game. So this is essentially for free-to-play players who don't spend any money at all. I recommend the Wave 1 Avenger team. And this team does very well in early arena, early raids, especially with healer ISO. They also can do well in Dark Dimension 1, which we'll talk about in a minute. And the great thing about Wave 1 Avengers is they're still a very good team in the late game. So, for example, if you look at my Wave 1 Avenger team, I've built them up into the high levels because they're a top 4 war defense team. And so that, I think, is really a great thing about this team is that they don't fall off in use. All right, that's why I'm recommending that you build this team if you're a free-to-play player. Now, I will say this. The other great thing about Wave 1 is that they're very easy to obtain. In fact, if you've started playing already, you've probably already gotten some Thor shards from a calendar. You also get some Captain America shards. You're going to get Hulk from some achievements. And then you'll be able to get Black Widow, Iron Man, or Hawkeye very easily. The best two on the team to pair with those core three are going to be Black Widow and Hawkeye. But you could even throw in Sif. Actually works well, even though she's not technically part of the team. She's available in the War Store, and Iron Man is a fine placeholder as well. Now, I have these other ones here. Dolphin is if you want to buy those offers that come in the game where you can spend a little bit of money to buy a character. Every 30 days or so, every character pretty much goes through the offers. So you just have to wait around to get the character that you're looking for. Hella comes around every once in a while, and she's a really key character in the game. I would consider her a top 20 character still or something around there in terms of usefulness in the end game, because she's so useful in Dark Dimension 2, 3, and 4. She's also useful in the Doom Raid, which is the end game raid. And the cool thing about this team, the reason I recommend them is they're decent in the early arena. They're good in the raids up till the early Ultima 7 raids with the right ISO. And then they also help you unlock 3 different legendaries. We'll get to that later. This team would require you to buy 3 characters, the most important one being Symbiote Spider-Man, the Symbiote team. And they're really if you want to spend more and buy 3 characters instead of 1. If you do that, these two you can farm. You could also just buy Symbiote Spider-Man, who's still more expensive than Hella alone, and skip these other two because you can throw a lot of other characters that with these the three symbiotes, Symbiote Spider-Man and these other two, and still do okay. Now, the reason I've recommended the Symbiotes is because they're a team that you really need to have for Dark Dimension 3 and 4 for the city section of them, because they're city hero and city villains. And then they also are really important in the Doom Raid, which is the end game raid for the bio nodes, because they're bio characters as well. That's where they get their power. That's their origin, so to speak. Okay, now that we've talked about the starter team, what are you going to do? You're going to try to get the shards for that starter team. You're going to try to put gear on the starter team, try to grow them from something like this to, you know, even bigger. But at a certain point, right, your starter team is going to poop out. Now, one thing I should say before we do that, before we get to that point, is I should mention to you that there's something called ISO that I've been talking about. This is ISO 8. It's from a special campaign, and you're going to need to use a global team to go through it. Wave 1 are mostly global, so they can help you here. There are other global characters as well. And I would recommend that you use this green energy, the ISO energy, to farm these ISO pieces and put ISO on your team. If you need to know what ISO classes to choose, go to our Discord, which is also linked below, and you can ask there. I've also linked the Voltage Sauce Beginners Discord, which is a fantastic place for new players to learn how to play the game. Now, here you can get these things called ions, which are a special currency to use with the ISO to equip that. But then you even get gear and gold. So definitely think you should use this stuff. And, you know, the other thing I would say to you is, you know, we've talked a little bit about, do you want to spend any money, you know, or also you're getting those power cores from Arena. What should you do with those? I get that question a lot. And what I would just say to you is, one of the most efficient things that you could do in the game is to actually buy the energy, because when you use energy to farm, you could just get all sorts of different things in the game for your energy. So, for example, here in one of these late game nodes, you know, I can get, for example, experience, which helps me grow in levels. I get gold. I get purple gear. I get some orange gear. I get basic orbs. I get these training orbs. So lots of value just from spending energy. It's very efficient. And by the way, whether you spend any real money or not, if you're just doing this for free, no problem. You can use these cores that you get, for example, from the arena, and you get from some of the achievements in the game, and you can use them to buy refresh your energy. Here, where you actually will, excuse me, I get back to the street here, you can refresh your energy. You get 450 core refreshes a day. I think everyone should do those. I do the hundreds as well, 100 core refreshes. So you do that, and, you know, that is a way where you can get some additional energy. You get 120 energy per refresh, okay? So that's sort of, I think, an important thing that people are overlooked in terms of what you should devote your resources to. One thing I will say is before you spend resources in the game that are rare, I really recommend getting some advice. One thing I should say is don't just look on the internet for guides. A lot of them are outdated. This one was made in March 2021. I'm going to try to update this over time, and certainly the stuff in the links below will be updated. But one thing I would suggest, particularly if you're going to buy an offer, is to just go into the Discords below, either my own Discord or go to the Beginner's Discord, and just ask players there, is this the right thing that you should be spending your resources on? Because you really want to make smart investments. This is a game that is not good for you if you're like an impulsive person. Impulsively just throwing your gear and your gold and your energy at things. It's much better if you try to plan out and have a goal and have a plan. So what's our plan? Well, we have the starter teams. We've already talked about these starter teams. But at a certain point, you're like, okay, what do I do now? I've got the starter team. I'm working on my starter team. I'm doing my raids. I'm doing my arena. Well, now at a certain point, you're going to have to start focusing, as I said, on Dark Dimension. Now, what I'm going to recommend to you, actually, is that you should be focusing not on Dark Dimension 1, but on Dark Dimension 2. Why is that? Well, Dark Dimension 1 requires 6-star characters. It really takes a long time and a lot of farming to get a character to 6 stars. So what I recommend you do is you, for these other Dark Dimensions, you could have a 2-star character and take it in, or a 3-star character. So I recommend you start in Dark Dimension 2, you beat it, and then your rewards here are going to include Ultron, a powerful character. You'll get him at 7 stars once you beat Dark Dimension 2 twice, which will be easy for you to do if you follow my directions. So once you have Ultron at 7 stars, you can literally throw Ultron with any other 4 characters that are 6 stars or above and beat Dark Dimension 1 easily. So I think that's the most efficient way to do it. Aim for Dark Dimension 2 and a Dark Dimension 2 team, unlock Ultron, and then use him with the first four characters you get that are 6 stars or above. All right. So now, how do we focus on Dark Dimension 2? What do we do for Dark Dimension 2? Well, I want you to take a look at an infographic I linked below. I'm going to show it on the screen now. It's called DD3 Theory. It's a DD3 infographic. This is for Dark Dimension 3. That's the abbreviation. But here's the thing. If you take any 5 characters from this infographic to Dark Dimension 2, you will steamroll Dark Dimension 2. Absolutely steamroll it. You'll have no problem whatsoever. Okay, just follow the guide here. Just pick any 5 characters. There's lots of characters on this infographic. And why am I suggesting you do that? Well, look, DD2 is easy now because of the power creep that I told you earlier. The characters have gotten more powerful. We have ISO, which we didn't have when DD2 was created. And if you use characters that you take to DD3, it's going to be very efficient. Why? Well, think about it. If you essentially, when you invest gear into a character, you never get it back. You can't take the gear off of, for example, Hela or Symbiote Spider-Man once you put it on. So that's why I suggest that you focus on a starter team that you can carry to the late game. And then you also use characters for DD2 that you're going to also use in DD3 and DD4. So all the characters on this list not only are great in DD3, they're also great in DD4. So you need 5 characters to enter DD2. Any 5 characters. So take 5 off this list, any star level, you're going to be fine. And then you can start working on, after that, once you beat DD2, you can take Ultron and beat DD1. And then you'll be able to, you'll have all this orange gear that you can then use to start building a DD3 team. And as I say here, DD3, you can have 3 global. This is broken into sections where you need 5 characters at gear tier 14, which I'll teach you about in a second, to enter. And then it's got 3 different sections, global, cosmic, city. So in DD2, you just need 5 characters total. For DD3, you need 5 to enter, but then you need characters sufficient to beat the global section, cosmic, and city. And these are basically like essentially the areas where they're from. And each character has this tag, global tag, cosmic tag, city tag. And you just need 3 of these, 3 of these, and 2 of these. See the symbiotes? That's why I told you to build them. And there's Hela. I told you she was going to be important. Okay. So, you know, what do you need to get a character into Dark Dimension 2, 3, or 4? Well, it's very simple. You need to get them up to the right gear tier. So as you upgrade these characters, you're going to see tier 11, for example. Here's a character over here at tier 13. This is the gear tier that you need in order to get a character into Dark Dimension 2. Now, as you get further in the game, you'll realize not only do you need to get your hands on orange gear, which is hard to come by, you're actually going to need these things called uniques, which are right here. You actually have to get these. You're going to have to look out here in the game where in the supply store, and you're going to have to try to buy them for gold when they pop up here, or you're going to have to try to get them in the raids. You know, you could potentially try to look for certain orange gear in the raid store. You can also go here in the war store if need be to get the uniques that you need. The point that I'm trying to make is, as you go along, it becomes harder and harder to get the levels of these characters up. So you want to play it carefully. You don't want to waste your gear. You don't want to, for example, gear the wrong characters and start struggling. So that's why I'm telling you, if you use the orange gear on a character that you could take to all the dark dimensions, that's a really efficient way to go. Now, over time, what that means is you're going to take some of the characters on this infographic and you're going to have them be the highest geared characters in your roster. I recommend not putting orange gear on any character that you're not taking to DD2, DD3, and or DD4. So these are going to have to be the characters that'll make your arena team or raid team. And the great news is this list is full of great arena and raid characters, or at least characters that are good enough for arena and raids. And what I would suggest is you go to one of the Discords below and we'll help you work with whatever team you have. And just ask some questions. We'll help you make them into a good arena or raid team and get you through the content you need. The cool thing then is if you take these characters and you use them to get by in arena or use them to get by in raid, you may not be quite as good in arena or raid in the beginning, but you're playing the long game. What you're going to do is by getting through DD3 and DD4 quickly, you're going to get better characters and more gear so that you can use all that orange gear eventually to make this amazing arena team that you want or raid team that you want, but you got to get there first. So the only advantage you have over the older players who've been playing for a long time, they've had more time, they've gotten a head start on you. They've had more time to farm and to get the gear and the characters. Your advantage is you don't have to invest in the old power crept characters. You invest smartly in the new characters and you race to the finish line. That is how you get to the end of the game. That is the path to power. Now, over time, you're not going to just have one team. Of course, you're going to have multiple teams. And you're going to start ultimately in the game, you know, building teams. For example, you're going to have to build many teams to succeed in Alliance War. But one thing I will just say is I would not put any focus on going wide in the game. In other words, building, you know, 5, 10, 20 different teams until you've gotten to where you need to be through the Dark Dimensions. Now, certainly your alliance may demand that you have a certain number of attacks of an alliance war, and you need to do the minimum you need for your alliance to not get kicked out. But, you know, for example, Blitz is a game mode where, you know, having a lot of different teams can help you. But all I recommend you do there is use your spare gear, the gear you have tons of, like your green gear or maybe later on your blue gear, on Blitz characters. Otherwise, focus on Dark Dimension. Get through those. Get those big rewards. Now, one thing you're going to hear about from a lot of content creators, maybe if you look at other guides, is legendaries. And what legendaries are is they're characters in the game that you unlock by farming up other characters and using them. So here are the legendary characters. And for example, having all 5 of the Asgardians, who we mentioned on our beginners teams, will unlock Black Bolt, for example. Okay, so you know, there are definitely characters that you can aim at to farm the legendaries. I'm not going to go through all that here, but here's a myth that I want to debunk. One thing that you're going to hear that's absolutely false from various videos and guides is that MSF is all about the legendaries. It's not. If you look at the top 10 or 20 characters in the game, very few of them are legendaries. And a lot of these legendaries aren't important at all. Now, some of them are, but for example, Iron Man isn't important, Star-Lord isn't important, Nick Fury isn't important. And some of these characters, I would say, have a niche use. You know, for example, a new player really doesn't need Magneto or Invisible Woman to succeed. Do they have some uses? Sure. There are some important ones. Doc Ock is still an extremely important character. Jubilee has an important team, or a very powerful team. I don't know if it's necessary. It's a skippable team. It's an important team, a powerful team. These two characters are very powerful, Black Bolt and Phoenix, and sure, he could be helpful in raids, but none of these are the most powerful characters in the game, and they shouldn't be the focus of your plan. So a lot of players ask me, well, what should I be farming? Should I be farming certain shards, certain gear? What I would say is, don't be just farming to farm. Don't farm shards of a character just to get a character, just to get gear. The goal is to advance and make your roster more powerful. Have long-term goals. And for a player in your position, that needs to be your starter team, Dark Dimension 2, Dark Dimension 3, Dark Dimension 4. That's the path to power. That's the path to getting all those humongous rewards that I showed you. Dr. Doom and Ultron and all that orange gear and red star orbs and gold star orbs and all that stuff that you get from defeating those game modes. That's the way to do it. Now, along the way, you are going to have to unlock certain campaign nodes. And sometimes people will ask me, well, should I focus on Dark Dimension or should I focus on unlocking these campaigns? And the answer is to focus on the campaigns when you need to get you through the Dark Dimension stuff. So, for example, one key thing that a lot of players are trying to do at a certain point is to unlock this node to farm Hela because she's so good in Dark Dimension. Well, that's a very worthwhile goal. And what I would say to you is, particularly for these first three nodes, what you want to do is you want to use actually one of the teams in the starter guide right here on those first nodes in the upper, the one here in the upper right can be used to unlock those first three nodes of the villain 7-1 through 7-3. That's what you're going to want to do. You just put Healer ISO on the Sinister Six with Zemo, who's a very powerful character. They're all farmable. No problem, you can get through those villain 7-1 to 7-3 nodes, or you build a Hydra team just like this. Now, there's also, to reach villain 7-1, however, you're going to have to actually go to the Heroes campaign, and you're going to have to face Heroes 7-1 and beat this. And what players ask me is, well, this takes City Heroes. What do I do? What City Heroes do I use? And it's actually very simple. And you're probably going to laugh because it's some of the same characters I've already told you about. Hint, hint, I'm steering you to the powerful characters. This one character alone, Symbiote Spider-Man, if he's big enough, if you've taken him to Dark Dimension 2, for example, he can solo those nodes by himself, Hero 7-1, for example. He does a little better when he's paired with Anti-Venom, who's also a character that's hard to unlock. These two characters alone can solo those nodes. And if you don't have one or both of those characters, then what you do is you use Squirrel Girl, because a Squirrel Girl and her team actually give Drain to Miles and Miss Marvel, and those three are very useful. And you could pair them with, you know, certainly Moon Knight and Night Nurse and White Tiger now have some value in the late game if you have those characters, or Daredevil. Ghost Rider is also a pretty strong character. Those are the characters that you want to focus on. Don't focus on the Defenders or some of these older teams. They're not very good. They've been power crept, okay? So, and similarly, when people ask me, should I focus on working on the Doom campaign, the Doom War campaign, or should I focus on Dark Dimension 3? The answer is only focus on the Doom War campaign to the extent that you need to farm these orange gear pieces, particularly these, what these are called, mini uniques, to get your characters to the gear tier that they're needed in order to get into Dark Dimension 3, because you need your characters, five characters at gear tier 14 to enter Dark Dimension 3. All right, so I hope this video was helpful for you. This is just a start. It doesn't tell you everything you need to know in the game, but it gets you on the path to power, the path towards building that beginning team and then getting it to those Dark Dimensions and getting those massive oodles of orange gear right away so that you can upgrade all the best characters in your roster to high levels and get a powerful roster as soon as possible. All right, if you want more information, if you're a newer player or a mid-game player, go to our Discord below. We have a great community there who loves answering your questions. And also, you could go to the Voltage Sauce Beginner Discord below, which is a great community for newer players who are just getting started in the game. And obviously, if you enjoy the content here, press the like button below, subscribe, and you could also check out my Twitch stream. I answer questions from new players there, and Voltage Sauce comes on regularly to do that as well.